So, MoYu have made a magnetic Meilong 6x6. I'm not sure. I think they have actually redesigned the Meilong 6x6 as well, and even potentially made it slightly smaller. Because if it was just a copy of the original Meilong 6x6, I'm not sure if I'd even bother getting it just because it has magnets. I'd probably get like one for myself, but I'd have to check it first to see whether it's even worth considering selling. But if they've updated it, then it might not be terrible, but I'm not going to get my hopes up at all. Okay, so it's actually even smaller than the Aoshi WRM. Right, new calipers as well. So let's get my caliper out and we can have a look at the exact 69 or 60.9 or even 61 millimeters, which is pretty small for a 6x6. Like, I'm aware of 4x4s, modern 4x4s that I still sell at market stalls, cubing competition stalls, that are bigger than that, like the CEMS 4x4, which is 62 millimeters. This is a 6x6. However, that's not really the relevant point. Let's have a look at the performance. If you did want a smaller 6x6, is this something worth considering? Because YJ never made a Zilong 6x6. They only went up to 5x5 with that series of small puzzles. I suspect if they did make a 6x6, it would be about this size. Maybe a millimeter smaller, but I don't know. So yeah, this is incredibly tight out of the box. And I don't think it's fair really for me to continue a video unboxing of this without at least loosening the tensions a bit. However, just to make that clear, I am doing that. Okay, so it is a lot faster now. I've loosened the tensions about one whole turn on every side and it feels a lot better. However, I'm going to completely mess it up just to see, so I can feel, I feel like I might have gone too far with loosening the tensions, possibly. But it's also kind of a factor with the cube of, yeah, is it really that stable? I think they've realized that the Meilong 6x6 is not stable enough to have tight, to have loose tensions out of the box, because suddenly it would start popping, which is unfortunate for a budget 6x6, because most of the people who are going to buy a budget 6x6 really don't want it to pop. They probably have no experience fixing pops, and unfortunately that's something people are going to have to learn with a 6x6. Regardless of which one they get, I think. Unless you want to perpetually keep it on insanely tight tensions so it never pops. Or you have really accurate turning so you never pop it. But I think obviously most newer cubers certainly don't have accurate enough turning that they don't pop 6x6s. However, this is a lot better than the original Meilong 6x6, definitely. And I haven't popped it yet, so that suggests it's not as much a concern as I feared it would be. Yeah, so I'm just going to keep talking and finish this solve. So yeah, I mean, it's very interesting that MoYu have released this. I don't know exactly what their thought process is with this. I don't think I've actually listed it on my site as I'm making this video, so I haven't got a price, but I suspect it's going to be the same as like the Yufu Yuxi V2M, or possibly slightly cheaper. There's also the Yuxin Little Magic, of course, which is £13. Unfortunately, though, I don't think this is better than either the yuxin little magic or the yuxin V2M. I think the yuxin V2M is an incredibly good 6x6 for £14, and it would be way, way more popular if the MGC wasn't only £5 more expensive. If the MGC was like what most flagship 6x6s have been over the years, then the yuxin V2M would be way, way more popular, I think. Unfortunately, this doesn't quite compete, and I think the only place in the market is because it'll probably be like £2 or £3 cheaper than the yuxin V2M. Like, if you want to save £2 or £3 and get something that unfortunately isn't as good, like this, the yuxin V2M, I think pretty much will unanimously be preferred. However, corner cutting isn't bad. However, I feel I'm about to force quite a bad lockup without forcing too much corner cutting. Yeah. Like you can see, it's just not wanting to go even. So in conclusion, I can't really recommend this puzzle to many people. However, if you're in the market for a specific priced 6x6 that's magnetic, this might be the one for you. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe.